And we're about to take up a condolence resolution for the passing of a former member. The clerk will please read the resolution.
Whereas the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania wishes to honor the memory of the Honorable Babette Josephs, who served with honor and distinction as a former member of the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania, and who passed away at the age of 81 on August 27, 2021. And whereas, born in Forest Hills, New York on August 4, 1940, Ms. Josephs earned a bachelor's degree from Queens College in 1962 and a Juris Doctor degree from the Camden School of Law at Rutgers University in 1976. She worked as a teacher in Philadelphia during the 1960s, a lawyer during the 1970s, and as founder and director of several advocacy groups during the 1980s. Lauded as the longest-serving female member of the House of Representatives of Pennsylvania, Ms. Josephs was elected to her first term in 1984 and won 13 additional consecutive terms representing the 182nd Legislative District. During her tenure, she championed LGBTQ rights, women's rights, racial equality, and environmental responsibility. Ms. Josephs was a member of numerous legislative and party committees, including the State Government and Game and Fisheries Committees. Appointed to the Pennsylvania Commission on Crime and Delinquency in 1993, she hosted a public access television show, served as a board member of the local chapter of the American Civil Liberties Union, and was a member of the Jewish Labor Committee and the Center City Proprietors Association. Ms. Josephs enjoyed cooking, painting, and fiction writing. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the House of Representatives of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania proclaim with enduring sorrow the passing of the Honorable Babette Josephs, and extend heartfelt condolences to her son, Lee Newberg, daughter, Eliza Master, six grandchildren, and many other family members and friends. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution, sponsored by Representatives Bryan Sims, Joanna McClinton, Michael B. Carroll, Angel Cruz, Pamela A. DeLisio, Dan Frankel, Mary Louise Isaacson, Eddie Day Pashinsky, and Steve Samuelson on September 7th, 2021, be transmitted to the family of the Honorable Babette Josephs.
Those in favor of the resolution will please rise and remain standing as a mark of respect for the deceased former member. Guests will please also rise as able. The resolution has been unanimously adopted. Members and guests may please be seated. On the resolution, the chair recognizes the gentleman, Representative Sims.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, Representative Josephs was a powerful, dynamic, and a very memorable member of this great body. Every single member who served with her has a story about what it was like to serve around her, what her influence was like, what my mom would call her gumption. She had a massive impact on Philadelphia and a massive impact on the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and the impact of her presence is felt every single day here in this chamber. Unfortunately, none of her family members were able to join us, but seated in the gallery are some of her former staff members from her time here in this chamber. They are Bill Boehm, Matt Hurlbert, Jen Bells, Tara Hannah Taliaferro, Helen Norton, Chris Hayes, Marianne Spaziri, and I believe Kim Heilman. On behalf of this chamber, Mr. Speaker, thank you very much.
Chair, thanks, gentlemen, and thanks to the staff for their service. Speaker recognizes Leader McClinton on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and thank you to our colleagues for remembering Babette. Babette was not the first woman to serve in this House, but there is no doubt that she was certainly one of the most impactful of what I like to call our sister reps in the last 100 years. She holds the record for the longest serving woman here on the Democratic side of the House, second only to Eleanor Taylor, and the length of service by all of the women who have served here completely. Babette represented the good folks downtown in my hometown, the Center City of Philadelphia, for 28 years with a strong, unapologetic, progressive voice. She had a real knack for challenging the powers that be, both Democratic and Republican. And she was sure to persuade everybody to think about the topics they otherwise may not consider. In the earliest years of her career here in the Pennsylvania House, some of Babette's colleagues thought that her positions were too liberal to even be taken seriously. But of course, with time, everything changes. Views evolve, outlooks, and of course, legislative priorities. And we were able to see Babette set out to achieve so many goals that are now routinely accepted by everyone. She represented Center City, but she was seen and her work was felt far beyond the blocks of her very own district. She fought for the civil liberties and for the rights of people that she had never met and would never meet all across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. She was a fighter for the poorest among us, for the sick in need of a doctor, for students who were going to school in perpetually underfunded schools, for communities to be safe from gun violence, and for people everywhere to have the right to choose their very own reproductive decisions. She was a proud member of our Democratic Party, the Philadelphia Bar Association, ACLU, Americans for Democratic Action, co-founder of NARAL, and the Pro-Choice Caucus here in the House. Babette lived a life guided by principles, and she put those principles into practice every single day. Many times, as I'm very familiar, she was sometimes on the losing side of votes here in the House, but even then, she would not hesitate to speak truth to power. For 12 years, she was our chair of the State Government Committee, opposite a number of different Republican chairmen, including my counterpart, Leader Benninghoff, for a period. Babette understood her role on the committee very clearly, whether she was in the majority or in the minority. She was there to fight against discrimination in every single form, to protect democratic goals, ideals, the right to vote, defending democracy, and ensuring the best practice in our elections. I did not have the privilege to serve alongside Babette, but in the summer of 2015, Mr. Speaker, among the many people I went and had one-on-one meetings with during my special election, Babette Joseph was one of them. She sat down with me and talked to me about her journey here in the House and her different campaigns and the number of them and how they went. She gave me some encouraging words and a little help that I won't talk about. I didn't have the privilege to serve right here with her, but I'm so grateful to have heard many stories, to have known her personally, and also to know that she has made a distinctive mark through service in this chamber. She was one of the rarest legislators who became easily identifiable by a first name, Babette. She was also a leader, a fighter, in the most noble sense of words, a mother and a grandmother. She meant a great deal to this House, and I'm appreciative to all of our colleagues for taking time this morning to express our sincerest condolences to the generations of her family, and of course, to our caucus staff, some who are still here and others retired that are present today, who worked alongside of her with so many years. She will be missed, and certainly her legacy continues to outlive her. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Chair, thanks the lady. The chair would also like to share one of the stories that the good gentleman from Philadelphia had related. I had my own experience with Chair Josephs very early on. My first two terms, we were in the minority, and she was the chair of the State Government Committee at that time. And I'll never forget being someone who has a respect for the institution. I went to Chair Josephs and requested that she move one of my bills. And as a freshman member, she obliged. And I think it was in large part, to anybody who knew Babette, we had a lengthy conversation about the Strasburg Railroad in the district and her love of trains. And I always appreciated making that personal connection with her in that capacity. And I think that's something that all of us as legislators can do, because by the time we got to the end of the conversation, the bill that I was asking to move, Chair Josephs was more than willing to do it. And I think that we all could learn a lesson from her and terms of seeking out those personal connections. Despite our disagreement on policies, which were numerous, we still made that personal connection in terms of working for the betterment of the Commonwealth, and I always appreciated that opportunity to work with her and learn a little bit more about the legislative process. So I for one, missed working with her as well after the first two terms. But all right, with that, I ask the Sergeant Arms, please close the, or open the doors, excuse me. of the House, and that'll conclude the memorial service.